It's a song, Gelan.
Yeah. Sure, Rasta. Orinda. Sure, thank you, man. Thank you for coming. So we are going to make it a very easy one.
Yes.
So people have always wondered, who are you, where are you from, and what are your real names, where were you born, and what's the inspiration, and what do you think about South Africa? And then we're going to talk about the typical ones. Just already now think about the top five portraits that you have done, especially posthumous portraits where someone has died and then you are doing that portrait. So those are the things that we are going to discuss. And then at the end, you tell them how you make a living and how can people support you, because they are always wanting to know about that so they can support you. Let's start. Who are you? Where are you from?
My name is Levani Sibwenje. I was born in Zimbabwe, Bulawayo. Yeah, from a Mozambican father and a Zimbabwean mother. I grew up in Zimbabwe, Acres, like in Pumla East. Some other boys will be playing football. And I'll be busy lying at my space at home, doing my pencil sketches, doing my art.
Sure.
I realized my talent when my grandmother used to come from more rural areas like in Plumtree, was in Yama. She used to come in and say, Rasta, Lebani Tara, by that time, not Rasta. Yeah. Please do some sketches for me, then I'll do some sketches, then she will follow with the different types of colors and my threads to do the painting. I used to go with her to other houses, do my sketches on the walls, those round hearts. Then she would follow that with different colors also to paint that. So she's the one who discovered my talent, like, you're gonna be a good painter. Amongst my mother, she used to say, "Ay, Wena, you must concentrate on your school books rather than things." But yes, my grandmother, she was the only one that encouraged me. Flashback, when I came here to South Africa, that was 1996 after school. And I got to school like 94. I had to stay a kaya, going to Botswana, Plumtree, doing some business and stuff. Then I had to come to South Africa for greener pastures. I came here, I did woodwork, carpentry work, construction work. Eh? Then from there I went to restaurants. I was a barbecue restaurant, like a scholar, cleaning up for my dishes and stuff. Yeah, but the talent of art was still with me. Whenever I would be paid, I would go and buy material, then sketch. Sometimes on my weekends when I'm not working, I would go and sell my work. Street lights, my robotics. Sometimes I'll go hook my stores and go sell my works.
Sure.
Up to the point when that was 2003. That was my first painting, when I painted the late Brenda Fassi. I went there, it was packed, you understand, with these funerals and memorials. So I was even chased, what are you doing here? Then I went outside the venue, I had to paint, sketch, then, oh wow, this is a good work,
yeah.
So from there, I painted even the late Sisulu. I painted, hey brother man, I painted the late Sisulu. I painted.
Is it hot there?
Yes, it's hot, my brother man. It's so hot. I painted, I was Sisulu. I painted Chopek Mayor, Amos Masondo by then.
Yes.
Yeah, people.
So, what was the occasion, guy, Chopek Mayor, Amos Masondo?
I was celebrating because that was the first parliament.
Okay.
Nelson Mandela after. I painted Vele on Nelson Mandela.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the Joburg mayor was just congratulating the mayor, yabo. So it was hard for me even to get closer to the mayor with a painting. But I had to pass the report card to take the painting to the mayor. I don't know, maybe he received it or not, but that's where I started my painting. From there, people recognized me in events like Abo June 16th, of which I will carry a painting. Abo Sharpeville Massacre, Women Rights, all these holidays, your Freedom Day, each and every time I'll go to Pretoria and paint. So it started there with Abatubeti. Rasta, you can do like anything now. It's being recognized in that way. Yeah, understand. Okay, I'm an artist now, super artist. Everyone noticing me whenever I attend every event. It went on and on up to when I painted the likes of Abo HHP. That's where it started. Abo the late Mandoza. People were like making noise, like discouraging, like criticizing my work. This is not the guy in a painting.
An artist once needs a critique.
But by then, Lami, I had to push because it's my calling. I guess it's my calling because I feel it whenever there's this thing that is happening. I feel what I have to be there. And pay a tribute, especially to our icons, to our legends.
So I want you to talk about the politics as you come nearer to South Africa, as you come to today. We are talking the politics coming this side. Mother is Mozambican, father is Zimbabwean. Do you identify as Umthwakazi?
I can say Umthwakazi. I work with them. Umthwakazi. My mother is from Zim. Ubaba is from Mozambique. So Umthwakazi, I've been working with them. I've got a deeper understanding and roots with that culture, as my mother is from Indigenous culture.
Hold it there. There are people who are having lots of debates, and in Africa, we listen to people and we hear what they say. So your father is Mozambican, your mother is Zimbabwean. She's a Ndebele woman from Wabulawayo.
From
Plumtree. Very beautiful place, Plumtree. So I want you to explain this. Do you think you are a South African, number one? Because now that you're here, do you identify as a Mozambican? Or do you identify as a Zimbabwean from Kwabulawayo? What do you identify with?
I will just simply say I'm an African.
Yeah, an African.
Yeah, because when we go with these boundaries,
they divide us.
They divide us in a way that now my mother is from Zim, my father is from Mozambique. I'm here in South Africa with South African kids. I can't point one country and say I'm from Zimbabwe. Of which when I go to Mozambique, when I go to Zim, same story. And mind you, in Botswana, because Plumtree is just along the Botswana border. So my great-grandmothers are from Botswana. The name Levan is a Kalanga name from Botswana, of which
you are a full South African.
It's three countries.
So what I've done is I've spoken with a lot of Umthwakazi from Bulawayo, and unfortunately people from Mashonaland do not want to speak to me. And I still challenge you guys, I dare challenge you that come and sit with me so we can learn more about South Africa. But you are going to end up saying, "Now I love Amandebele more than I love Mashona." So I've always said to them, the first thing that I would want for them to be achieved is for number one, South Africa, no, Southern Africa,
yes,
as a SADC countries to be combined as one.
Yeah.
But I'm going to leave that for now because I don't want to talk those politics. And when you came to South Africa, because you did Botswana and stuff, when you came to South Africa to come to settle, do you consider yourself that you were an economic migrant or you were an African person who was looking for economic opportunities? Just understand the two questions. If you are coming here because of hunger, it means you are running away from your own country. But if you came here, you feel as an African you needed to go anywhere. I hope my question is clear.
Yeah, yes. At first, I was out of school when 94. So I was so very young. I was 19, 20 years old.
Yeah.
So coming here to South Africa, it wasn't because of hunger and stuff. For me, by then, it was just a style of you hear some other friends of you in South Africa. So it was like that thing. What do you mean?
Calling. Fashion.
Yeah, fashion.
Oh, so.
If I'm in South Africa, then I'll be wearing those nice clothes and stuff. It wasn't young because I was very young, not same commenting because I've got those responsibilities.
So, in other words, you are saying people who live in Zimbabwe, let's just talk about the they see Gauteng as people from Cape Town see Gauteng, people from Durban see Gauteng, people from Polokwane see Gauteng. It's local for you. It's a place that you need to go maybe to study and is that what you say?
Yeah, as I say, it wasn't like I'll come to South Africa for it.
Yeah.
It was just a style.
Yes.
When I'm in SA, then stuff and stuff.
All right.
It's not like now, which I want to be coming for the hunger. Now, you can't say that people are coming for stuff.
Economic situations have changed between then and now.
Yeah.
That's what you're saying.
Yeah, it has changed a lot.
All right.
For me, it was just the fashion.
Yes.
I'm young, then I will be just like Ubani.
Yes. So let's talk about this. It's very tough now. It's very tough. So if you live in South Africa, I don't know how often you go home. Do you find that economic situation at home has deteriorated far from what you left it, or is it better?
Back home, there is not easy, my brother, as I can say. Just like from here, Joburg, Pretoria now.
People are hustling, people are working.
People are working. This is a big city, just like in Johannesburg.
Yes.
So the way I can explain, it's not easy. Guma rural areas, like Guma cities is. Yeah, we are in the city, everything is here, it's in the limelight.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're down there in the rural areas, there's nothing that is happening.
Yeah.
So with us to move is to go and hustle and strive for more.
Okay, thank you.
Strive for more.
Thank you.
It's not easy.
How many Zimbabwean political figures have you drawn?
I've drawn quite a lot. If I can say, I've painted the late His Excellency President Robert Mugabe.
Mm-hmm.
I painted the president now, Emmerson Mnangagwa.
Okay, you've got RRG.
Yes.
You've got Mnangagwa.
President Mnangagwa. I've got Umkomo.
Okay, Joshua Nkomo. Okay, you've got banana?
I don't have
banana, okay. You've got three.
Yes.
You've got the big three in Zimbabwe.
I've got big three in Zimbabwe.
Okay.
I've got the late also, not Uchamisa, still the, the president.
Yeah. Yes.
I've got Tsvangirai.
Okay, yeah, then Tsvangirai, may his soul rest in peace.
Yeah, Morgan Tsvangirai as well. I've got ama athletes like from Zimbabwe, the players like Abo Moses Chunga, Abo Dumiso Kumete, Abo this guy who passed from Botswana, Raman Kumbo.
Okay.
Yeah, those legends. I've been painting also Abo Quentin Sanga. I've got ama politics and athletes and
okay. I spoke about, do you have a relationship with your father?
Relationship?
Yeah, relationship with your father. Do you?
Yes.
Do you go to Mozambique or is in South Africa or is in?
He's in Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe. But do you go, do you know your home, where your home?
Yes. Yeah, he took me to Mozambique like 5 years ago. Since I couldn't go there, I didn't know my other
But family. Where in Mozambique are you from?
It's in Tete.
Tete.
Malawi.
Oh no, that's way far out.
It's way far.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it took me like 5 years back when All right. he retired. Yeah, he was working in Zimbabwe and came to South Africa. We met here, we worked together, then we went back to
People underestimate how far that place is. With a bus, it will take about 3 days.
Yeah, it's
from Maputo to go up there. Yeah. It's way too far.
Yeah, it's way too far.
It's like Malawi, that place.
Yeah, it's there.
Okay, let's come back to South Africa. So, in South Africa, you are embraced. You are loved as one for our own.
Yes.
People, I mean, there are a lot of Zimbabweans who have been accepted into South Africa, and you are one of them who've been loved and accepted in South Africa for various skills and everything. You've got kids in South Africa. What do you feel about South Africans? And I keep telling South Africans that when someone says this is how they feel, they are not enforcing it to you. You are not forcing them to love you. You are not forcing them. You've got kids and they've got South African identity. They live in South Africa. How would you feel if they are mistreated? Because you said you belong to a lot of countries. How would you feel if South Africans are segregating your kids and not wanting them to belong as South Africans?
Thanks for that.
Sure.
I once said to my other colleagues, Uguti, it's going more deeper when we think of our foreigners and stuff in South Africa. Because now, Mina, as I'm in Zimbabwe now, Mozambique, yes. I'm here in South Africa. Then I've got Abantwana that has kids. South Africa. Yet Mina, I'm a foreigner. So for that, it doesn't rule out their place here in South Africa.
Yes.
They are South Africans. Now, umtanam senga taleli banyana banyane taleli Springbok, then she can be ruled to go to, he's from Zimbabwe.
Yes.
He's from Mozambique.
Yes.
He's from what?
Botswana.
Yeah, because now sesihlangene abantwana bami now labo bathi bangama South Africans.
Yes. Because they
take
are.
Them to Mozambique. I can take them to Zimbabwe.
Yes.
Yeah.
So do you think we need a SADC passport?
I think so. Because for now, even when we go with this, as I mentioned, like xenophobic way, Asisela stand on that because sesing abantu abanye now.
Sure.
We are together now in a way. You can ask me ukuthi ngingubani. I can even say I'm a Zulu.
Yes. Yes. Because remember, don't forget, I've said it a lot on this podcast. It's in Ndebele. Sakwa Bulawayo. Samatebele land. It's actually Zulu.
Yes.
It's actually Zulu, by all intent, by its history, by everything.
That was our advantage as well as the Zimbabweans are Mandebele. When they come from Zimbabwe, it's easy to sound like a Zulu because
you are Zulu.
Abantu abakhuluma isiShona sometimes kuyabavalela ukuthi bekhuluma isiZulu.
And believe me, this podcast, I don't want to go into the deep politics of amaShona and amaNdebele, but but I want people to click at the end of this because then they will see the difficulty and the differences between Amashona and Amandebele. But I don't want to go there in this podcast. So let's talk about South Africa. Give me the top five political portraits that you have done, especially the posthumous ones when someone has passed. Gayton is lucky, he gets to see his own drawing. Who's this Karabo Mroka? What do we call Karabo Mroka?
Konifika.
She's lucky she has seen a drawing while she's still alive. Let's start with at the back. Who's this? Who's this at the back? You tell us.
This is the late Obaba Patrick Dlovu. Obekuzona 14 years Obaba Mloyi.
Sure.
Yeah, and painted when he passed on. That was when last year.
2023. Yeah.
When he passed on. So we don't call it.
We call him Principal Ayizo Yizo.
Yeah, Principal Ayizo.
Okay. Yeah. So now let's go back to the top five that you remember.
Top five.
Yeah. Political portraits, especially at funerals, posthumous ones.
That's Nelson Mandela.
Mandela.
Omama Omadikizela.
Of course.
Desmond Tutu.
Dad.
Omlange.
But in Drumlange, okay, yes,
that's only four.
It's fine, you can count as many, but we want the top five.
Yeah, but I can mix because now it's only politics.
Yes,
because Ngenga Bayenza and about the recent one you painted, oh, Baba, which I'm not screaming.
Okay, yes.
Good morning.
Yes.
Yeah. So, yeah, you love big five, I
yes.
say, but. I'm not like bouncing with them.
Yes.
I've painted Nelson Mandela.
Yeah.
And I've painted Abanye Abantu like on the ground. If you look at my careers, Abashona, like Abu Kroki, Abu HHP, the Ricky Ricky.
Yes.
Abu Tunemba, the few.
So yeah. I want us to talk about this. You've got South Africa, ne?
Yeah.
You've got Zimbabwe.
You've got
Botswana.
That's Mozambique.
You've got Swaziland.
That's South Africa.
I want the Kenya one, ne?
The Kenya one.
Yeah, I want the Kenya one. I want to wear the Kenya one. So this is Gaza.
Yeah.
You support Free Gaza.
Yes.
Because you are a full-rounded Southern African, and we spoke about this. So tell me, why do you think you want Gaza to be saved?
One thing for sure, war is not a thing.
It's not a nice thing.
It's not a nice thing. Apart from Ogutisilola, you understand that we can fight. Now you're young into Silanga. You can go back to Zimbabwe.
Sure.
I think we finally learn it.
Sure.
Sure.
Yes.
Kula Mandebele adip dip. Kula Mashona adip dip.
Yes.
Tina, so sing a chibuti. I'm a 2000.
Yes.
I can say, or equal free.
Yes.
So it's struggling. It's about corner between the village and Shona.
Okay.
If we can dig to it, villages will come.
So you are saying.
Just like even Lana in South Africa, the struggle is to lie. About to see Lola Pogoti, Tomyama, Dungeon, Fadelana. Nina, Samogutin is pushing forward. I will always fight with someone that doesn't know. Just understand. So, Mina Kalamuti is item of when we get to reach this kind of conflict, which is a war. Maybe one party must go down and say, let's find a solution.
Thank you very much. So you are saying
no solution. Imagine Singapore and Kula in Zim.
Yes.
If I can tell my daughter, she's a 20-year-old daughter now.
Yes.
I'm sure now.
I got a problem.
Yes. My neighbor, Shona, did not doubt us. You understand? There are other peoples that are deep in rural areas that they can't even pronounce Shona name or they can't even say it.
I understand.
The economy is Shona.
Yes.
Yeah. No. Why is Shona?
Yes.
Shona, why is
Shona?
But this generation, I think, so we're going to see the history of what happened.
So, in other words, for you, what happened in Kakura Hundi must be forgotten. What happened when Zilikazi arrived in Mtwakazi and conquered Shona tribes? And let's forget. Let's build
we
a one nation.
We have to forget and respect one another.
Yes.
Let's not just forget and seriously cause a havoc within those communities. Because now, abantu they are moving from one place to another.
Yes.
You find a Shona now. You say shala kovula wa yule business.
Yes.
Then those indigenous people. See, I know the show now in the business.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
Those things so many things for the end. Mova mind you find the two unta na missing a tandana long to put this show.
Kuba no conflict.
The conflict. So,
yes.
Let's just forage
sharp.
Yes.
And
just like Manji apartheid.
Yes.
Manji,
we will never move forward.
Yeah, we always like John 16, we remind ourselves what people were brutally killed. Okay, that's the history.
Yeah.
Like, it mustn't be like on that okay. Right?
Yeah.
We have waited. I want to know what happened.
Yes.
Because onko muntu ashobunizo.
Yes.
No matter onga check out what is the people people were slaves. Way big. Why are we not fighting those people?
Yes.
Now, Tina, we are fighting each other in a way of waiting. In the way I'm fighting you. It's
yeah.
Super easy. Even when you check in South Africa now, when I'm a Zulu now, I will ask you, are we a vendor? Yes, I'm a vendor. I changa nilela, I vendor.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not happening in one country. It's happening everywhere
in Africa. Thank you very much. So here's the thing. I have spoken in the past with Bumtwakazi, like I said. What I've been struggling with, I've been struggling to get the sentiments of Shona people to say, guys, come. There's a lot of hate propagated between Shona people and Africans. And when we are silent, it's as if we don't see the persecution that Amashona feel. I have spoken with Rutendo, saying, Rutendo, please, come and sit down. Let's sit down. It's important because you have Rutendo has retracted the bad words he said about Amandebele. He has retracted them, and I still think he's misunderstood. He has not stood on a public platform to say, guys, Shona people, let's make unity with Amandebele. Let's speak. Let's go. And let us dispute all of these things and sit down and talk for peaceful means. And I want you to use this 30 seconds to appeal to Rutendo, to appeal to Mapong, but to say, guys, there's a responsibility based on you to change the mind of the few Shonas or the majority Shonas who still have this hate, to come for peaceful means, to have a sit down and talk about peaceful, positive things about this soft war.
Yeah. There are people like Abo Joshua Maponga.
They've got lots of influence.
Yeah, they've got influence. Mina, one-on-one in Maponga. He Botswana, he attended it. I think that Joshua Maponga. Yeah, I had even Abantu talking about it. Why are you saying Rasta? Are you a Shona or are you a Ndebele?
Yes.
That one I mean in Fisher because people were saying it.
Yes.
Then Joshua Maponga is you invite her somewhere, it doesn't ask me what. At first, when I met Maponga, he greeted me in Shona.
Yes.
Ah, so we say,
yeah.
Then he, mommy, Yeah. He realized that he's not a show.
Yes.
Then from there he didn't even care about that. Then he went on to Ndebele, Shona, English then.
Because Maponga grew up in Bulawayo.
Yes. Yes, then survived with that. Akazange even a problem. Then I'ma comments with people saying, but I understand. Why when are you allowing him? We are people from Pagans. We don't have to be what. Then when I told them, if you know what, I'm just African. In a way that my father is from Mozambique, my mother, Zimbabwe. Then there is no way I can fight Shonas.
Thank you very much.
I can fight Amandevenes. There's no way. Because I don't even belong.
Yes.
To Zimbabwe, I don't even Shonas.
You are all over. So here's this. Thank you very much for doing that. And I hope Zimbabwean people can understand this with peaceful means. Vumthwakazi, you have made a stance. Now we're waiting for Amashona to come so we can have these peaceful talks. Because the more the influential people who rutendo, we sit down, people understand that there's nothing. The country is much more, it's much more important than the rest of us.
And for me, Mina, Abantu, my name is Levani.
Yes.
Levani is a Kalanga name.
Yes.
Meaning Kulumani.
Yes.
Engalitata from Avoma Krenkren.
Yes. Yes.
Then people, they confuse that with my surname as Chirenge.
Yes.
Chirenge is a Shona guy.
Yes.
Then Levani is a Kalanga guy.
Yes.
This guy who Kulumis in Debe.
Yes.
Umshubani. Some other guys who let him greet me in Shona language. Like,
sure.
As you say, Rasta.
Yes.
What? Lami, I will take it from there, which I know. I'll,
but when does this say, says Rubo, and then you continue?
Then I continue.
Yes.
Oh, are you a Shona guy?
Yes.
We thought you were in Debe. Then the Debe guys were like, how are you in Debe guy?
That's the problem. Dozo. Can you please give me that? Okay, so I want us to do this, ne? I want us to talk I mean, just hold it. I want us to talk the portraits that you have, and then many others, they will see it at home. Tell me, what's the size of this one? Because now you're at a live exhibition. You are exhibiting your artwork, and people are coming for portraits. I want to go and release you to go and do your business. How can people get hold of you? And do you do private session where someone can say, Rasta, here my address, come, here's my deposit, come and work with us. I want you to do portrait for me, portrait for my family, take it, just advertise your work.
Yeah, apart from the funerals and the memorials that people see me there, I also do my anniversary. Your birthday, I can paint a 1-year-old.
Yes. Yes.
Your birthday, anniversary, anything, your promotion at work.
Yeah.
Anything just to do with the celebration. Maybe you have achieved something, you have bought a new car.
I
always do those paintings apart from our funerals.
So
then Nitolagala, simple.
Yeah,
Guma Social Zami, official Rasta, the artist. Mm-hmm. Yeah, all the way.
Alright, it's fine. What size is Gaten?
It's big enough.
It's okay.
My size is mena.
Just call it extra jumbo.
Yeah. Because it can be an 800 by 600.
Meter. Okay.
Yeah. This size.
This one, how big is this?
Yeah, this can be 800 millimeters then times 500.
Yeah.
It's almost a meter by meter.
All right.
It's almost like a square
so
meter.
So if someone does this, currently, do you give the price online or you want people to come so you can talk about the price?
The price, we can always talk about it. We negotiate the prices because Abantu abathole ngokufana. Abanye abantu, they will just come just to tease with, hey Rasta, can you do this? How much is that?
Yeah.
But I would see with this is a potential client which is ready or she's ready for this, then I give a price.
Yeah. All right.
Because with now with I really need this.
Sure.
Then I give you a good price.
Yeah. All right.
My prices can start from 3.5 going up.
Yeah.
For a small Indiana.
Yes.
This can be 10 to 12,000.
All right. All right. No, it's fine. Let me put this back so we can close. Untokozo is an artist by her own right.
Yeah.
Did you teach her or she just fell in love with?
Untokozo, she's a radio personality. She's a presenter.
Yeah.
I met her in the radio where I went to the studios.
Yes.
Then I saw the potential to her, which she can do anything.
Yeah.
I turned her apart from which I can't do. So I was surprised that one day when she came to me and said, you know what, I'm also an artist, like how I do all my houses that are crafted. I was like, let me see. Then she bought one house and that was finished.
Yeah.
Then from there, me and Nashu, then you can grow this with me, with Abuya speaking, son, Lama will help. I'm a paint, I will help with some other materials.
Yes.
She's here, she's the first exhibition. I'm happy over team. She's so very passionate about the incident. I'm not pushing you, and then I hope she's not just following me.
Yes.
She sees light at the end.
Yes.
And if I can work in general,
yes,
achieve something in life.
All right.
She's doing that.
All right.
I'm supporting in any way.
So she's your protege. This is what you are teaching.
Yes.
So in closing, Rasta, what is it that you want to say to South Africans? What is it that you want to say to all Africans in general about your work? Because now I'm done. I want to release you to go back and work.
For me, it's over consistency, over passionate, that respect, over humble, mental anxiety. Because if I wasn't gonna be here, there's a lot of my cuts along the way. I've been criticized, I've been threatened, like, we're gonna kill you, we're gonna cut your hands off, we're gonna do
for what?
For painting.
For painting someone?
Yeah. I've been threatened. My voice notes. It's so very serious. So
because the political ones or the normal other, is it political ones?
Yeah, like I'm an artist, yes. I paint whatever. So people from anyway, from political space,
yeah.
So from,
but they have not told you, let's say someone is threatening you, they do not tell you on which part is.
No, I haven't heard that. But you hear a voice note. We don't wanna see you.
At the funeral.
Yeah, this is sensitive. When you come in, do your things that are not right. I promise you, you won't survive. So I've been here.
Do you not think it's from other maybe artists? They want to enter your space?
They can do that, but I've seen it. I'm an artist now, which whenever I paint, you see, okay, Chidimma.
Yes.
There are some artists also who did okay, Chidimma.
Yes.
I'm challenging more Rasta, because
yes.
I posted this.
Yes.
People are like, okay, they
yes.
did their paintings also
yes.
just to challenge.
Yes.
I don't mind
right.
that. I don't have a problem
all
with
right.
that, because I'm the trendsetter.
Yeah.
Anyone can fall.
No problem.
But there's Rasta.
Yes.
There.
So let's talk about this. So people are saying, because I understand that's your style. All of these things, these are your styles. Sometimes you paint someone as is. It's like a photocopy, and these ones are very good. And people say, oh, you see Rasta, when he wants, he paints people this way. Sometimes he paints with the left hand, sometimes he paints with the right hand. What is it? Are these drawings, are they paintings? What is it?
Whenever I paint, I will be in a mourning period. period.
Okay.
As well as everyone will be mourning around that person.
In closing, so, are you saying you don't deliberately paint someone bad and someone good?
No.
All right, no. It's fine. Let me quit, guys. Let's say, all right, it's fine. Because they think, because I'm happy with that, because that's your style. I think any funeral that has a rasta, that's a rasta. People are already expecting, if there's a bereavement and you show on TV, if they see you, they say, I don't know. It means
some
that event.
Say, with a funeral without rasta is a boring funeral. Imagine that.
Yeah. No, thank you very much, guys. Thanks. Sure. Thanks for tuning in. Please keep supporting. Mashona brothers, please keep supporting South Africans in general.
Yeah.
Let's support. Sure. Any words of encouragement for Chidimma in Miss South Africa? Any words of encouragement you want to say for Miss South Africa? Any words of encouragement?
Yeah, for Nane.
Yes.
She must be strong, because Lami, when I started
it was tough.
I was like, who's this guy? Where is he from? We understand. But I'm from Africa, understand? Like, we don't know who to mama, who are we, but let's don't challenge each other like that.
Yes.
We've had our sports and culture minister, the platform, I heard what is challenging, who's that girl from?
He's not even challenging. He said, if she is South African, let's love her. But if she's not, let's just check. Because what he wants to do is just check. When the check is done, say, here she is, she's South African, then he wants to kill the story.
But what about my daughter? My daughter also.
Yes.
Namzali Lalana.
Yes.
She's a South African.
I guess she's got it.
Now, Ubaba Kengo Rasta.
I heard Gayton speak. Yeah. I heard Gayton speak. Gayton says, if she's a South African, it's fine. Whether the father is born, he doesn't matter.
Okay.
As long as she's Akri Hotel is born here, only South African certificate again. That's all Gayton is saying.
Just like check Silo Mtawarira, the beast.
Yes, the beast. Yes.
He's a Zimbabwean.
Yes.
But he's a... he's playing for
South. Historians are telling us that he's a Zimbabwean, but he's a South African. Understand? People don't mind. Because there would have been a problem if she goes to go and represent South Africa in Miss World, and we only find out she's not South African.
Just like me, I'm from Zimbabwe.
Yes.
Then just imagine now, in Ilashavan to Zimbabwe and say I'm a Mozambican. But I was born, raised in Zimbabwe.
Yes.
Then now I tell about, I'm going to Mozambique.
Yes.
Not gonna work.
Anyway, before racing, we know you guys are very harsh on these things. We love Africa. We hope you join us in loving Africa. Here's one thing.
Yeah.
Do you actually see I appear darker on the screen than you? Look. But you are Zimbabwean and I'm South African.
Yeah.
So if we are going to take IDs based on the darkness, I will be arrested. Yeah.
With that, I was talking to my friend.
Yes.
Long back when you came to South Africa, you had to dress nicely, I'm all stars.
Yes.
Your striped t-shirt and stuff.
Eish.
Not wearing as he isn't. Yeah. So you are Zimbabwean.
Because it's
but
tough.
Bakona, abo putivito, abo wealapa, zanini, venda, changani.
Yes.
They dress like Mozambique. Zambicano, Malawians.
And there's no problem.
There's no problem.
Guys, one love, one Africa, Malaysian politically incorrect. Thank you. Tell us what you feel about this, especially South Africans. Let me not tell you what to do. Thank you very much. Love Africa.
Peace.
Sure.